In the heart of the suburban jungle, where towering buildings loom and asphalt rivers flow, there exists a creature unlike any other. Meet the white lion, a majestic specimen whose tale is as rich and storied as the landscape he traverses. Here, amidst the hustle and bustle of modern life, the white lion roams with grace and purpose. His den may be small in size, but its significance knows no bounds. Observe as the white lion tends to his den, a sanctuary filled with relics of his past and treasures of his present. From the tools of his trade to the laughter of loved ones, each artifact tells a story of resilience and triumph. Triumph motorcycles, that is. When the weather is nice, the white lion prefers to travel via his Triumph Bonneville T120 Black. As a child, the white lion, not to be confused with Shelley Duvall, was introduced to his friend's dirt bikes. This was where he developed his love for the two-wheeled Titan. He got his first motorcycle, pictured here, in 1994. Now just look at that mane. You can picture it blowing majestically in the wind. Now, however, he sports a more aerodynamic look. Behold, the white lion takes to the open road on his trusty steel steed. With the wind in his metaphorical mane and the roar of the engine beneath him, he embarks on a journey of freedom and discovery, tracing ancient paths and forging new trails. Listen closely as we manage to capture once-in-a-lifetime footage of the white lion singing. But not all trails in life lead to happy endings for our ferocious beast, not to be confused with the hairless Johnny Bravo. And when things don't go his way, you can find him in his personal temple of fitness. Amidst the comforting hum of familiar machinery, the white lion emerges as a solitary sentinel of strength and perseverance. Here, within the confines of its own domain, he embarks on a noble quest for physical excellence. Starting from a young age, fitness has always been one of the lion's top priorities, and in order to maintain his physique, the white lion has a high-protein diet. This diet consists of various combinations that most would not find particularly appealing. Tuna pasta and plum sauce, one of the lion's favourite meals. Experts have been hypothesizing how this creature could enjoy such a dish, and they have all come to the conclusion that he must not, in fact, have taste buds. In the heart of his domain, the white lion assumes his alter ego, DJ Benka. With quick hands and a keen ear, he navigates the labyrinth of beats and melodies, sculpting sonic landscapes that stir the soul. Many could only dream of making such masterpieces one day, but for our talented lion, this is a casual, everyday occurrence. however, is a very special day for the White Lion, as 53 years ago today, he was born. You may have found out by now that he is, in fact, not a lion by blood, but by heart he is the mightiest of them all. Made in England, born in Canada, and touching the soil of over 15 countries, the White Lion's legacy extends far beyond the confines of a global scale. Across the savannah of life, he has left indelible footprints, touching the hearts and minds of all who have had the privilege of walking alongside him. Growing up with the White Lion as a father has led to some very interesting memories. My favorite memory would have to be the time that we went to the bay and he tried to pounce onto one of the chairs, but he miscalculated and he smacked his head on one of the glass panes behind him. It made the loudest bang I've ever heard in my life. I swear the whole store shook. It was so loud that it could have been mistaken for one of Big Ben's gongs.
And this was a really difficult assignment, not surprising coming from our baby. So difficult to come up with one memory because we've had so many wonderful memories together. But I go back to the silly thing, and probably the most epic silly thing that I did was when I thought that someone stole the minivan. And you had such hopes of getting rid of that minivan. You wanted a real car. You didn't want that stinking minivan anymore. And after we reported it and the cops came and, you know, we were about to leave the parking lot, we hadn't even made it to the road and the police called and said, "We found your minivan," and your hopes and dreams of buying a new car were destroyed in that very moment. The cops said that they found it at another entrance, and my response was, "Well, who moved it there? Because it certainly couldn't have been me."
So the best thing about working with my dad is getting to see him interact with people that he works with and hearing him change his voice. I like to call it the sales voice, sales quotas, accounts, baby. But I gotta say, my least favorite thing about working with my dad is I now have a fear of going to the washroom because he has a habit of coming into the washroom at the same time I am and throwing wet paper towels at me over the stall while I'm trying to take.
Happy birthday, Johnny. Sorry we couldn't be there.
For our funny story, we're gonna go way, way back, some almost 29 years ago, when I was struggling, to say the least. Ruth was in places she shouldn't have been, and Andy was struggling.
I was struggling big time, for sure.
And in you come to the delivery room and sit down and eat a bag of chips like nothing's happening. That's my funny story.
What I like about Uncle Johnny is when he carries me on his shoulders because it's really fun. What I like about Uncle Johnny is when he taught me how to scratch on the DJ equipment.
I like it when Uncle Johnny carries me to my room and buys me pizza.
Soon after I met you, I had a little accident in the kitchen at a little street. I slipped. In order to prevent myself from falling, I grabbed onto your butt. Well, it wasn't really your butt. It was your butt pocket. And I almost pulled out your pants. You didn't even move. Just loaded to your head and look at me. And I said, "Thank you, Johnny. You saved my life. And now you have me forever."
Jonathan Adams. I'm going to share something that's a little sappy instead of funny. I recall 3 days before Josh and Les's wedding, I was really struggling because I would always break down during my speech, and I would be practicing my speech for weeks. But I reached out to you and I said, "Listen, you being the father of a daughter as well, I need your help, please. I can't seem to finish this speech because I keep getting emotional." And I remember you saying to me, you're great, you said, "Mino, you got it. Alessia loves you. Just take a deep breath whenever you feel like you're gonna cry, or if you do, and just go with it." And you said to me, "If you're still struggling, just look up and you'll find me." And I remember doing that during the speech, and it looked up and briefly glanced over to you, and you were there, and it calmed me down and made me feel really good. And I remember finishing it, you know, pretty successfully. So that's my brief moment. Thanks for everything, Johnny. Take care.
Tell me what happened either last trip or the trip before involving a swimming pool.
So they were wrestling on the side
Who?
Of the pool.
They? Who's they?
Well,
Uncle Ben. Johnny and Ben.
Well, then they were, you know, wrestling. And then they, I think Ben pushed Uncle Johnny, and Uncle Johnny, you know, pulled him with.
And then they fell in the water.
Yeah, actually, no. Uncle Johnny pushed Ben, and then Ben pulled him in.
But
yeah,
like
okay. Mm-hmm. They both fell into the water.
And Uncle Johnny still had his phone in his pocket of his pants, I think. And yeah, then his phone. I was in the shadow part, I think.
Yeah, but
I think we all were, and then we all like raced out of the way.
Yeah.
Hey, Jonathan.
Hi, Jonathan.
So, do you remember the time that you made a bet with the kids, the soccer kids, and if they won, you would show up wearing a dress to practice?
And the next day you wore a dress?
A black dress that was really short, too.
Yeah, it was kind of sexy.
Right?
Yeah.
Right?
And you remember the time when we were in Mexico and you lost your $1 slipper and big waves were coming down and you wanted to go get it and you couldn't find it?
And you risked your life doing so?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And my favorite time, I think, is the time that... It was around the time that we watched Brokeback Mountain. And then that summer, Johnny showed up.
And he goes, Gina, you want to go for a ride?
And you jumped on the back of his bike and you two just took off into the sunset.
Yeah.
I'm Uncle Johnny. What's the big idea?
Uncle Johnny's a big idea.
Happy birthday!
Wishing you a happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Jonathan.
We love you.
Happy birthday, Uncle Johnny. Happy birthday, Janicita. Happy birthday. I wish you the very best today and always. And may we make many more happy, happy memories together.
In life, each animal plays a vital role in maintaining the delicate balance of its ecosystem. And just as every species contributes to the harmony of its habitat, so too does the white lion leave an indelible mark on the world around him. His presence is both essential and irreplaceable, shaping the landscape of his community with his boundless loyalty, unwavering compassion, and relentless pursuit of laughter. Today, we celebrate the mighty lion and his even mightier heart.